Asana tries to get it back inside, but turns it over. Now, Buono quickly, and DR Congo score again on the break. And suddenly it's a two-point game, and you wonder if Cheksaar might need to get a timeout. Oh! Boy, that was almost a turnover on Kaj.
And you know who's turned things around? Number 35 for DR Congo. He's come in and done some good stuff.
And Desai, the three, rims out, and Tabwe with the rebound.
And he gives him some extra size when Sacco's out of the game. And plenty of energy, and he's not using any energy up in the first half, so he's got plenty to give in this second half.
Here's another look at that sweet finish.
That's a tough move, double clutch. Sacco's back in.
Buono steps back, puts it up, and misses. Not sure that was the best shot.
He was under a lot of pressure there from the defense. Good job by Miranda.
And Desai for three. Good. There you go.
That's how they got to play. Let Gasana just dictate. He's like the conductor of the orchestra. And he lands the pass on the money. And Ndizaye is playing with so much confidence at both ends of the floor. Blocking shots, changing shots, and knocking down threes.
Well, Ndizaye certainly is a crucial player for this team. Defensively, with his length. Offensively, with his scoring. Here they are, almost forcing a turnover.
DR Congo having a lot of problems with this press. Sort of a zone press, but then they go into man as well. And there's the trap. Let's keep.
Oh, push called on Robbins.
They got the ball exactly where they wanted it, near the sideline. Two players converging on the ball, but Shamba is a tough nut to crack to try and get the steal off him.
Zumba and Wamba and Tamwe playing big minutes here and making an impact for the DR Congo. Oh boy, another great drive and finish.
Zumba and Wamba, that is tough again, exploding past the closeout and off balance puts it in off the glasses. Check this out again. The closeout was nowhere. Williams Robbins comes across and he just cannot stop that from going in. And DR Congo have come out the second half a different animal. And Tabwe has been a big factor. After all the issues with the shirt, he's come in and they are looking a different type of team.
Tamwe's played at UNLV. He's played at Texas Tech. He's actually left Texas Tech as well. Tamway reaches in that time and commits the foul.
Yeah, Rwanda are really being challenged here by DR Congo. All the momentum is with them. And now Rwanda have got to regroup. Get a really good shot here.
And good hands by Tamway, but they still get the jump shot. For Rwanda, they're keeping the scoreboard ticking over. And Tamwe, though, races down to the other end and hands it off to Sacco.
That's great to see those two on the floor together. It's good for DR Congo to have Sacco and Ntabwe combining like that. And Ntabwe's a real issue.
Yeah. And now Mnanga Shamba comes up with a steal and then swatted, chased down by Gasana. Kaj, dangerous pass. Gasana down low. I'll look at him share the basketball. Hagamuntwari, though, one pass too many.
Yeah, I think so, but Gasana showing his character there. Timing the block perfectly, chasing it down, but that was one pass too many. Gasana made the pass inside. Just go up strong, score or go to the line.
as eBay comes into the game. Maybe he'll offer a little bit of rim protection.
Yeah, this is key because if you've got Sacco and Ntamwe on the court together, you've got to have some size for Orlando.
Buono gets it to Ntamwe. Nowhere to go for him. Gets it out to Kibi. Gets into the paint. Oh, that was an air ball. Sacco comes in and throws it off his teammate in Ntamwe out of bounds. So it's going to be Rwanda back. Oh, no. They're going to say shot clock violation because the ball didn't hit anything.
Yeah, good defense by Rwanda there. Forcing DR Conger into a really tough shot. And good boxing out under the hoop as well by Agamantari.
Yeah, that ball went off Agamantari, but yeah, it was the shot clock violation, which because the Nwamba jumper only grazed the net. Well, the game has definitely changed. Ntamwa showing what he means to this team. Prince Ibe falls down, alertly gives it to Agamantari, but he travels.
To get the mop team on, there's a bit of sweat there, but Prince Ibe just can't get into the game. It, you know, falls down there and ends up with a turnover, and that's really unfortunate.
Did a good job though, knowing that he couldn't stand up. He was able to at least get the ball. You see his foot slipping there. Got it to an open man. It's Agamantari that perhaps should have done better.
Sure.
17 turnovers on Rwanda, just 10 for DR Congo. Three-point shot to Wono. Long rebound to Ntamwe. And decides to hold it up. Now Williams has it after the pass from Gasana. And definitely paying a lot more attention to him now. It's Fula that's guarding Williams. Now Sacco switches on him. Shot clock winding down, and Gasana gets in. Boy, that was about, that executed about as well as possible. And it was the poise and the control of Gasana which got them 2 points that time.
Robbins, I thought he was maybe going to, over dribble there, but the pass was right on point, and Gasana just cruised, eased his way to the basket, and high off the glass with the layup. That's a tough shot. The help coming over. Great job by Gasana. Just playing off. He's been the provider, and he gets the score there.
Kande in the game. This is Sacco. It's crucial for Agamantari and Prince Ibe to really contribute here to this Rwanda team right now. Fula to Ntamwe. Puts up a long three. And the rebound, now down low.
Great offensive rebound. Eric Kibbe with the finish. Got a box out. Got to anticipate where that this shot's going to go.
Gasana, shot clock winding down. Hands it off to Ibe. And I have to say, Gasana should have known better, but nevertheless, they hustle back. Agamantari, he doesn't need to put it up. He doesn't. And they get it over to Gasana for three. Agamantari comes in and commits the foul. I think that the pace defensively, I think that the DR Congo really kind of forcing the issue here, making Rwanda play a little bit faster than they want to. Agamantari is going to go out. Felt like he kind of struggled some. And instead, they're going to come back into the game, Rwanda, with Kazaneza, who didn't score in the first half, but did have a block and a steal. And five rebounds. No, he had. Jump shot. ties it. So they trail by 15 points. All the adversity that they have faced in this game, and DR Congo have come back to knock the game with 12 minutes remaining at 50-50. And certainly the, you know, Ekhoff has done a great job of getting his team to come out and really defend in this second half, because they have really gotten into this Rwanda team.
16-7, they're leading in the third, and the ball's got a little bit static. Maybe William Robbins is feeling the pace. They're not getting the open shots.
Well, Gasana's got one. He goes down. He's fouled by Buono, a three-pointer, and that. We'll get another look at it, but the referee was right there. He's definitely got the reputation of being a big-time shooter. And you can understand why he's upset, because it looked like Gasana came down with his follow-through with his right arm and just made the contact and then fell down.
Yeah, it was a clever play by Gasana. There was contact as the defense was closing out, but he exaggerated it slightly, and by the fact he fell on the floor, the referee's given it. But
they'll look at that one, I think, and realize after the game that maybe that wasn't the right call. Could be wrong.
Maybe Coach Ekhoff is having a word there.
Oh, they're going to say he wasn't in the shooting motion. So they're going to say the contact was not in the shooting motion. So
after the shot?
Yeah, they're saying it's after the shot. So
okay, so he's taking the shot, and maybe his hand's coming down, possibly.
It's kind of a way to get out of it, instead of giving him three free throws from Gasana. At least it gives them a chance to defend, I guess. Anyway, play defense.
This is a big couple of minutes now.
Whoa, a little fade back. Yeah. He's got some game, doesn't he, Javi Mana?
Yeah, I've really been impressed with him. Another good left hander, and the press immediately.
Oh, look at this. Empolio almost comes up with the steal. Prince Ibe puts the pressure on Kibi. Game gets a little frenetic, and maybe this is what Rwanda needs. Mtambwa gets blocked by Empolio.
They need energy in the game, so go with some energy, guys. Give the others a break. They can come back strong in the fourth.
Well, Javi Mana has certainly shown that he is up for the big occasion. Empolio called for the travel.
They still need to play in control. There was no room there to get through, and just forced it slightly.
Wish they'd fix the net while we're looking at it.
Just
everybody sees it, but it seems like nobody on the court sees the net. Just jump up and knock it down. Look at it.
Could have been a defensive foul there. I think it was Shamba who came across. His hands were down slightly.
I think Ojeyarobu, the Nigerian referee, is going to say, let's fix that net. No, he's not. He's
going to. Could one of the players just grab
the
net and pull it down?
They could. You would think that certainly one of the Rwandan players would want to do that.
Running high, and Chiksa's got to get this team going again.
Well, they're able to break the press easily that time. It leads to an opportunity. Kibi gets blocked, though. Had a hand in the face. Offensive rebound by Fula, puts it up. And Prince Ibe with the rebound.
Good job by Prince Ibe there. Really important. He contributes positively.
Javi Mana now gets it back to Ibe. And knocked out of his hands. Puono sees the opportunity, and he scores, and he has a chance for a three-point play, and that all happens after the turnover from Ibe.
Nice hesitation, and again, protects the ball, left-hand layup. No help's able to get to him, no chase-down block this time. Three-point play coming up.
And here you go, folks. DR Congo has stormed back to take the lead against Rwanda, having trailed by as many as 15 points. And how about that? The net being up on the rim didn't bother him. Sangwe, now the turnover. Sangwe puts it up and in.
What a block by Kande, though, to thwart the initial layup, and the pressure and the energy is up.
And suddenly Rwanda get life again. And it's always against the run of play. And they have called the foul on Sangwe. The block.
They've made some great shots, spectacular shots.
You saw that play there, and then that was the steal by Empoyo. So that's how they got it, and suddenly, just when it started, you know, you're really worried for Rwanda there. They've come back to take the lead. And at this end, maybe a tough call. Could have gone either way. They've called a block. So this allows Congo's Mnangagwa, who hasn't scored in the second half, he's got 16 points, to go to the line and register his first point of the third quarter.
This is good for Rwanda with the starters and the stars, if you like, on the bench. They've got this group with playing with so much energy, putting the press on, getting steals, making big plays.
There's only 0.1 second remaining here in the third quarter. So looking up at the scoreboard, there's still time. Rwanda should have just sent somebody streaking down the floor. Okay, we're gonna, I think if you're Rwanda here, you just don't even do anything. You just throw it the length of the court, because there's not enough time to get off a shot. There you go, that's a smart move. So Kibbe's attempt is short, but it doesn't matter. And, Rwanda trying to hold on by the skin of their teeth right now. They lead it 57-55 over Democratic Republic of Congo at the end of the third quarter.
That beach is just too